Okay, been a little bit longer than I meant it to be for this one, and I also wanted to get in another trick and treat video in before this, but I've been neglecting this account for a while, and you leave it alone for too long, you like get kicked out of your fleet and whatnot, and it's because this is an MMO, of course, and trick and treat isn't, so I can just safely go back to that one when I have the time. So, let's go ahead and do yet another mission with the crew of the USS Perth Amboy. Actually, you know what? What I'm going to do first is I'm going to go ahead and do some house cleaning stuff here. But for you, it's going to go straight into the mission. But for me, I just got a little bit of stuff to take care of here. Okay, now that we know the ship can turn right, left. That was the problem I was having before. Let's go ahead and do the next of these missions that I'd skipped with this character, the Doomsday Device. Starbleep believed that the Klingon... Okay, voice is still not... Okay, at least I spotted it this time. Okay. Starfleet believed that the Klingons were testing their new weapons in the Yamaka system. We have information that now leads me to believe that these testing programs are for something much bigger than a new kind of torpedo. Starfleet Intelligence has received a message from someone claiming to serve in Ambassador Bavat's personal force. This source says the ambassador's research is complete and that he's planning on using some sort of a doomsday weapon on Federation worlds. My aide, Lieutenant Van Ziel, will join you for this mission. Go with her to the Donia system. Bavat has a small supply base near one of the outer planets. Our source, a man named Kavalk, says that we will find the information we need to stop Bavat there. And there are just a bunch of
Admiral Quinn says you're the right officer for this job.
Oh, that sound works fine. All right. Well, let's just transwarp on over there. Begin, Doomsday Device. You're actually not going to get to see a Perth Amboy for a fair chunk of this mission, if I remember right. You actually get handed over a bird of prey for a little bit. Okay, well, Van Ziel's saying, he's like, yeah, okay, we arrived. Intelligence told Admiral Quinn. Contact the Defense Fleet, he's one of these vessels. Looking for direct approach. Okay. Got to disable one of these ships and board it. Before I do that, I can actually get one of my endeavors while I'm on this mission. Or, actually, no, focus, Brian. Okay. As soon as the game will let me.
Whatever you need, sir.
Okay. Okay. Sometimes these things take a while. While I'm waiting for that, and so some of you may be aware that Magdalene Rose of the YouTube channel, well, Magdalene Rose, formerly known as Super Princess Tea Party, has been letting me run the Facebook fan page for the channel for a while now. And just recently she went ahead and gave me the go-ahead to launch a Discord server for it, and that launched today, the day I'm recording this, and it's already got 10 members. That's not bad for the first day for a fairly small YouTube channel. I mean, bigger than mine. I mean, she's got like over 6,000 subscribers. I haven't even hit 60 yet, but I'll go ahead and include an invite link in the show notes for this video, because why not? Mags is good people. Skeleton crew, scourges, just securing the ship. Okay, let's go ahead and take care of this little mission thingy here. Okay, I got NPCs helping me, but I appear to be on my own for the most part here. Okay, fine. I can live with that. Alright, so. Alright, whoop. Wrong way. My fault. Okay. If I remember right, this engineering section tripped me up last time. Oh, no, no. Actually, that was pretty easy. Okay. You're on a secure, but Gamma Squad is reporting that there are a few Klingon left on the bridge. Lock down the turbo lifts, but we have main engineering. We can take control of the entire system. Okay. Simple enough.
Whatever you need, sir.
Prisoners to the ship are secure. Remaining Klingons are being transported to break for holding. So the ship's log. Okay, information in the ship's log. Let's go ahead and do that. Right. Here we go. Ding dong.
Captain's personal log. I have been betrayed by my first officer, a man I consider my friend, Kabala. Why? He and a group of traitors tried to take the ship. Kabala is the only survivor. There is also evidence that Kabala sent a coded message to Federation space. I do not understand why a warrior I have trusted with my life would do this. Need to listen to the words of a traitor. Rot in the brig. Ambassador Babot has ordered me to bring him to the Umami system for questioning. Kabok will die screaming. It is not an honorable death, but it is the one Kabok deserves.
Okie dokie. So we're, out of the survey now. Alright, so let's go back to the turbo lift here. And we go to the brig. And we will look for color. don't speak to you through a force field like a cage animal, let me out, we can talk. Okay, no problem. Okay, here we go.
You are my enemy, but today you are my only hope.
Okay, I hope y'all heard that.
I will redeem my honor.
Okay, you know, I'm not gonna worry too much about this. I mean, if you were really, really that interested in the lore, you probably wouldn't be watching this Let's Play anyway, because, again, the whole point of this is to go through the missions that I skipped with this character, which means I'm already passing over a bunch of stuff. But basically, for those of you who don't know, Bavat found one of those planet killers, like in the classic Trek episode Doomsday Machine, and Kvalk considers it to be dishonorable to use that kind of weapon, and hence why he's betrayed Bavat. Okay, here we go.
Repair this ship, and we will fly it to Epaga together. Then we can disable the energy drain so your fleet can enter. With your help, we can destroy the Doomsday Machine and end the threat to your Federation.
All right, let's do that. Prize transmission from Earth, 31. Okay. Right. Go window to the bridge.
It's risky, but Tvalk may be our best chance to stop Bavat and this planet killer. I'm notifying all available ships to change course for Imaga. Once the energy drain is taken care of, they'll move in to support you. I don't need to tell you how important it is to stop the Doomsday Machine before Bavat can use it to attack populated worlds. Millions of people are relying on you to save them. I know you can do it. Good luck.
Millions, so like, no pressure or anything.
Yes, Captain? Understood. I'll join you shortly.
Alright, let's do this. I really don't feel like doing the ground stuff over and over again, so there's a trick you can use to get around. Oh, sorry.
From the planet. They're not calling for ships, so either they haven't noticed us, or they think we're supposed to be here. We're safe for now, but that could change. We need to scan one of the generators maintaining the energy drain to get all the information I need to finish a new command program. Be careful. Bavat trusts no one, not even his own men. He may have defenses in this system, even I don't know about.
Okay, let me just go ahead and set my crew here. The stations. Oh, really? Oh god, I hate it when the game just decides to deactivate a bunch of my traits like this. And. Oh god, it is so maddening. Okay, I'm gonna have to. Okay, I can't do that until I'm back in a social zone, like on the map or something, so fuck my life. Okay. Alrighty, let's see, I'll use, character named after my father for shield boost, Skavrin for health, and Tarsi for heavy torpedoes. Okay. Alright, now let's get on with this. A classic bird of prey. I guess the Klingon mode of thinking with these designs is if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Drones. Okay, so I should take care of that. There we go. Alright, one down. I have to deal with these damn drones again pretty soon, aren't I? Alright, whoop, oh, maybe not. Oh, shit, 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 yeah, okay. It's going a little faster than last time, I think. Last one of these, thank goodness. Okay, the part with the actual Doomsday Machine itself is gonna take a while, because there's a trick to really hurting it, but it could be really tough to pull that off without getting blown up several times. But we'll get to that when we get to that. We'll burn that bridge and we cross, as my dad always used to say. Torpedo thing, that's actually part of it. They might have just seen that little purple torpedo effect there. What that does is that does extra damage to Doomsday Machines, but you gotta fire it in directly into their maw, i.e. where the big one-shot, you know, the one-hit kill weapon comes out of. And that thing has a massive firing arc, too.
Remember that you're a Klingon now. Try not to look too out of place.
And here we go with my team. Oh, cutscene.
The objective here is simple. Find a control console and change the command codes. Then Bavat won't be able to stop us from shutting down the energy drain. There are two consoles. The Alpha console is staffed by an officer who might be willing to negotiate. The Beta console, let's just say that Commander Tok prefers fighting to talk. The soldiers here shouldn't challenge you, but be careful of the TARDIS. The hollow emitters won't fool them. I have another task. Meet me back here when you are done with the command codes.
Okay. So, like I said, there's actually a trick to getting around the Targs. There's like a certain, like, achievement you don't get for it, but, you know, it's really not that big of a deal in the scheme of things. I'm not really missing anything particular. So, let's just go ahead and cut through the weeds, as it were. This place kind of reminds me of that one part of that island in the Skyrim expansion. I'm blanking on the name of it right now. Not the name. The expansion was called Dragonborn. I just mean the island. I think I might have actually cut a little too far. Whoops. Okay, well. It is still... No. Okay, come on, here we go. We'll get this over with pretty quickly. Alrighty. Yeah, okay. Yeah, here it is. I can do this. There we go. Yeah. Fuck you, Targ. You ain't getting me.
Captain, I've been monitoring your progress from the ship. You are very close to one of the control consoles. There are Klingons where you need to go. You will
you don't
need
say.
To convince them to leave their post, or find other means of getting access.
Uh-huh. That's nice. Okay, this is the guy I gotta fight. I know. Yep.
No one is allowed to use this console. Death to the enemies of the Empire.
Alright, well, that takes care of that one.
Still more to do before this dark day ends, and my honor is restored.
Alrighty, let's do this. I love how nobody asks questions about... Oh, shit. Targs, gotta look out for Targs. Okay. Nobody asks questions about why these guys are, all carrying Starfleet weapons. As for the flickering, I think that's just added for dramatic effect. I don't think any of the actual characters see them. see. He's able to get around those targs pretty easily, huh? Well, easily is relative, I guess. This fight should be over pretty quick. Okay, board my little ship here.
Captain, Klingon comm traffic just spiked. Babot's forces have lost control of the Doomsday Machine, and they are scrambling all available ships to try to stop it. I've been in contact with Commander Burgess. Now that the energy drain won't affect our ships, forces inbound. We need to get back into space as soon as possible.
Oh boy. Okay, this part's probably going to end up taking more than half the video. Let's be real. Doomsday Machine can be a bitch to fight at lower levels, and...
The planet killer is here. Maybe it has a weakness that we haven't found yet. We need to run a scan. Go to the navigation. That should be close enough for the scan.
I already know what the weakness is because I've seen the episode many times, actually. I am a Trekkie after all.
Structural integrity holding, sir. Shook up, but we'll be okay. Captain, there's an unauthorized shuttle launch. It's kablonk. Hail coming in, sir. I'll put it on the main screen.
Stay where you are, Captain. I'll handle this.
Kavok, turn that shuttle around. You'll be killed.
My life is of no consequence, but my honor. No, I must do this. Destroying this abomination is the only way to redeem myself. Farewell, Captain. Koi Kalis Poo Blood. Koi Puk Beh Poo. Yako Mako Jeshu Kui. Se Machu Me. Mashu Mana Tvang Pok Tu. Nipe Ima Jan Mo Ku. Barba Hem.
I'm reading significant damage to the Doomsday Machine, sir. But it's still active. Captain, we still have the Harpang torpedoes. They might be enough to finish the job. The machine's hull is solid neutronium, so targeting it won't help. We'll need to fly in front of the Doomsday Machine and launch the torpedoes down that thing's throat. The fleet will be here to help distract it, but we need to be careful. If we're in front of it when it fires its anti-proton beam, we won't fare any better than that moon did.
Yeah, you don't say. Okay. Here's the thing with this. Okay. There's a trick. You can tell when it's about to start firing. What you want to do is actually try to get as close to it back here as possible because of how wide its forward firing arc is. Some damage in on that one. Yeah, get used to seeing that respawn button there, folks. This mission is a bitch. Okay. Alright, I think it should be somewhat out of range for that one. Okay, good. I gotta angle it just right. This mission so much, you have no idea. Oh, hey, I'm already doing pretty well, though. I mean, down to 38% after I've only been blown up once so far. Of course, there's the slight problem of all the other Klingon ships trying to blow me up while I'm trying to stern her freaking frigging. Okay, I can use a little help here. Let's call me. Ah, lucky for me, I have... Oh, shit. Okay. You know, honestly, getting in a good hit might be worth letting myself get blown up once or twice. Take as long as I feared. Wow. Okay. Awesome. Awesome sauce. Oh. Yes! Ooh. Fuck it. Oh. Well, the good news is... being blown up there, it's only mildly embarrassing. I still won.
Captain, Commander Burgess is patching a subspace signal through to us. The message is from Kronos, sir. Routing it to the main view screen now.
Captain, my name is Commander. While the Empire realizes that you played a vital role in defeating a threat to both our worlds, I am afraid I must insist that you return the ship you stole immediately. I would not want to have to escalate this into something that we will both regret. The battle is over. We do not need to begin another.
No argument here, and besides...
It might be best to do what he asks, Captain. The fleet's in no condition for a prolonged fight, sir. And honestly, there's not much about the Bird of Prey specifications that Starfleet Intelligence doesn't know already. We did what we came here to do. Let the Klingons have their little victory. and the fleet can take you and your crew back to your ship. The important thing is that the Doomsday Machine was destroyed. I'm sure Commander Burgess will want to congratulate you for a job well done.
Okay, so hold on just one second. I'm going to, see, okay, there's an endeavor there. One of them is, you know, harvest two materials in space, and I can do both of these before I warp out of here. I'll just go ahead and get that out of the way. But yeah, that was a Doomsday Machine mission, and yeah, this, I've done it a few times before. I think this may actually be the fastest I've ever completed it. So that makes for an awesome video right there, not gonna lie. I dig that. I'm glad you were here for it. Hopefully you'll be here for future Star Trek Online adventures with the USS Perth Amboy. Hopefully you'll actually get to see more of the Perth Amboy this time. And, of course, there's always the Magdalene Rose Discord server. You can find me there. And, yeah, that's it for this session, folks.
Kavolt's loss is unfortunate, but he did what he believed he had to do. In the end, he died with honor. Fortunately, you were able to destroy the Doomsday device and end the threat of Bavat's weapons programs. We probably haven't seen the last of him, but at least now he's disarmed. At least as much as any Klingon, that is. And don't worry about having to return the IKS Targ to the Klingons. I don't believe that there's much about that class of bird of prey that Starfleet Intelligence doesn't already know. If getting the ship back lets the Klingons think they've won a small victory, I don't mind, and you shouldn't either. There are very few captains who can say they faced a threat like you did today and lived to tell the tale. Impressive work.
Okay, let's see. Shields I'm just gonna sell anyway, and a crew officer I'm gonna get rid of anyway. Oh god, that thing looks so ridiculous. Okay. Alrighty, well, let's head on out. We're gonna warp right through the rock. It's hilarious. Okay. Okay, so now that's it. I know I said that was it before, but that was before Commander Burgess barged in. Alrighty.